Okay, so the first thing you need to do is preheat the oven to 400 degrees. Yes, the photo does not show 400 degrees. Next, you need to peel and chop one medium onion. Make sure to get that outer peel off of it. It's real tough. You don't want to eat that. I like to use a yellow onion because it's sweeter. It's not quite as harsh as a white onion. And then once you've done that, you want to go ahead and just chop it up, dice it into small pieces. Voila! Onions! Okay, next for the potatoes. You're gonna need either three large, like, baking-sized potatoes, or in this case, the potatoes I got were smaller, so you'll need about 4 to 5 smaller ones. And you're gonna start by just peeling those and rinsing them off, because potatoes grow in dirt, and you don't want dirt on your food. So make sure you peel them and clean them off real well. Potato, 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 potato. Now you're going to cut the potatoes into small pieces, bite size, marble size, etc. I'm kind of weird. I like to use an apple core to do this because, number one, it's quick, but also it's real easy to get everything the right size. You get all of the sort of outer flower petal pieces of it are real easy to just chop into, like, you know, 4 sections. Those are bite size. And then the center part, it makes these really cute little, you know, perfectly circle round pieces of potatoes. Yeah, I know I'm weird, but they're cute. However, when you are using the apple core, make sure that first you cut off one end of the potato and just manually cut up that little piece so that you have a flat edge for the potato to sit on. Because potatoes are slippery, and if you try to cut it without having that flat side, it's not good. You'll see in the outtakes at the end. It's not new. My love won't wait. Don't. No. So here you can see the cute little round I was talking about. Isn't that adorable? And here I'm just showing you the general size of the pieces should be. Like I said, they should be bite size, marble size, etc. I hope this way. Ooh, ooh, ooh. When I feel like this and I want to. Voila! Potatoes! You're gonna need a 2-quart baker, like a casserole dish, with a lid. You can't see it in the video, but you need to spray it liberally with cooking spray so it doesn't stick. The other ingredients you're going to need are shredded cheddar cheese. I would say at least 6 cups, but possibly more. You will need a stick of butter. You'll probably use about 6 tablespoons of it, but have a whole stick. You will need sour cream. This is probably the hardest to gauge. I would say probably about 8 ounces. You definitely don't need the massive container I'm showing here. And then you'll need garlic salt and paprika. This dish is all about layering. It's nearly impossible to screw up because you just toss everything in there. Basically, you're going to start with the cheese, put a liberal amount in there, enough to not see the bottom. And then you're going to sprinkle in the potatoes. Oh my god, no. Call the SWAT, we have a jumper! Okay. So, as I was saying, you put the potatoes in a single layer, no potatoes on top of each other. That's all right for you. That's all right. Sprinkle on some of the diced onions. Now you're going to take the butter and you're going to take 5 large pats. You're going to put 4 in each of the corners and 1 in the center. And next you're going to dollop on sour cream, just, you know, random rounded teaspoons throughout the layer. That's all right. That's all right. That's all right, Mama.
You're going to sprinkle the whole layer with garlic salt, and then sprinkle the whole layer with paprika. And now you're going to repeat. You're going to put a whole lot of cheese on, enough to where you can't see anything underneath. You're going to cover the whole layer. Then once you put on the cheese, you're going to press down and pack it down. You're trying to make as much room as you can in the baker. And then you repeat. You put a single layer of potatoes, sprinkle on some onions.
I'm leaving town, baby. I'm leaving town for sure. Well, then you won't be bothered with me hanging around your door.
Then, once again, five pats of butter, dollops of sour cream, garlic salt, paprika, and once again, cover the whole thing with a liberal layer of cheese. Once again, you're going to push down, kind of pack everything in. Now you're going to sprinkle paprika on the very top of the layer, and you're going to cover it. Put it in the oven. You're going to bake it for 75 minutes, and then you need to remove the cover and put it back in for another 15 minutes to brown on the top. Once that 15 minutes is up, go ahead and remove it. It's going to come out all bubbly and steamy, as you see here. Allow it to cool for about 5 minutes or so, and since you've used so much cheese, you are going to have oil on the top. So go ahead and take a paper towel and just soak up some of that oil, toss it out. Just a note here, this is the first time I ever used Walmart cheese, and Walmart cheese is the suck. This was the oiliest cheese I've ever seen in my life. When you make this dish, it's a lot of cheese. Please use a good quality cheese, not necessarily name brand, but find a store that has a generic brand better than Walmart's. Shouldn't be too difficult. Get a nice big spoon, dig it out, put it on the plate, and enjoy. One thing you will notice is the sour cream kind of melts down and creates its own little version of cheese, like its own little ricotta. Oh, it's incredible. Voila, sour cream cheese.
When we kiss, my heart's on fire, burning with a strange desire.